Hi everyone, in this video I want to give you a quick guide on how to get started with computer programming using Java. Although I'm not going to discuss what computer programming is, because if you Google computer programming on YouTube, you'll easily find some great videos on it, so I don't see any point of making one myself. I'm just going to focus on getting started if you're specifically using Java with Eclipse. However, I do want to point out that for me personally, and maybe this can apply to you as well, my goal in computer programming is not to win competitions. I mean, it would be nice to do well in actual competition, but I care more about learning how to solve problems, because the more problems you solve, the better you'll be at problem solving. I also think that this is a very good way to learn how to code. Maybe you're just trying out a new language, or you just want to maintain your coding skills. Plus, it's a great practice for coding interviews when you start looking for a job. So don't get put off by thinking that you have to be super fast and super knowledgeable if you want to partake in this activity. Just try to keep it fun. Because even doing easy problems is still a good exercise for your brain, and you'll get that sense of satisfaction for solving these easy problems. Of course, you'll want to progress to harder and harder problems, and hopefully you can then apply the stuff that you learned during your studies. But don't be scared to try, because some of the beginner problems are really quite easy. Now, of course, we're going to need problems to solve, and personally, I like Kattis, which you can find at open.kattis.com. By the way, it's not www.kattis.com, it's actually open.kattis.com, so make sure you go to the right address. And it's pretty much just a repository for programming problems. It's nice because you can quickly find problems based on the difficulty level that you're comfortable with. So if you go to problems and you can sort according to difficulty, you can start with any of these like 1 point something difficulty problems. So this is what I'm going to be using, but there are many other similar sites like CodeForces, HackerRank, LeetCode, or if you want something a bit more interactive, Coding Game. Kattis is newer, so you might not have heard of it, but I just like it because it's also used by the guys at NUS. That's the National University of Singapore, and they have a series of books on competitive programming that I use. Anyway, let's pick a simple problem. I'm going to go with this computer science. Each problem is going to start with a description of the problem, basically telling you what you need to do. But sometimes this can have a lot of fluff, which are irrelevant. For example, if you read the paragraph here, it's going to say something about temperatures in winter, and you're asked to find the number of days on which the temperature was below 0 degrees Celsius. But all that is not important, because when you read the input and output sections, they'll tell you exactly what they want you to do. And in this problem, it's actually very simple. You'll be given two lines of input. The first line tells you how many numbers it'll give you. So for example, in sample input one, the first number is 3, and indeed they give you 3 numbers. And the second one, the first line is 5, and they give you 5 numbers. And all you have to do is work out how many of these numbers are negative. That's it. Obviously, to be able to do this problem, you have to be able to read user's input, as in we must be able to input the numbers to the program. And some of you may not know how to do this in Java, so that is what I'm going to go through next. In Java, we can use something called the scanner class. So I have a simple Java template here. I'm going to make a new object of the class scanner, just going to call it in. Now, this is not the only way to do this, and in fact, there are faster ways to do it, but I think scanner is just the simplest way to do this, so it's good when you're just starting. So I made a new scanner object here, which is associated with system.in. You kind of think about that as what Java uses to take keyboard input. I'll give you a quick demo on how this works. We have an object called int, and now if I type in, I need an integer, so I'm going to say in n equal to in.nextInt. This is a simple program that will just take one input, one integer input, in fact. So if I run this, nothing's happening, nothing's coming up here, but actually the program is still running because you can see the stop sign here. Right now the program is running and waiting for you to input a number. So if I put in a number, let's say 5, it will stop. Well, that's not very interesting. So how about if we output what we just input it. So, well, let's do 3 times n. So So if I put 5, I should get 15 on the console. So let's run that again. I'll put in 5, and indeed I get 15. Of course, if you want to, you can have more than one integer input. Let's say I make an integer m and input that as well. If I run this now, and I just input one number, the program will be waiting for me to input the second number. So right now, 5 goes to m, and now still waiting for n. So if let's say I type in 7, then it will do the next line. You can also input the two numbers separated by space. You don't have to press enter. So for example, I can type 5 space 7, and it's going to treat it as two different integers. Basically, Java is smart enough to work out which of these are the integers. You can also read a whole line if you want to. You can read many things, in fact. If you look at the next here, you see there's like next in, next byte, next short. There should be next float and next double as well, or next long. If you want to read a whole line, then the command is surprise, surprise, next line. We have to give that into a string. Well, I'm just going to print out the string, I guess. I'll run that. I can write hello world, 1, 2, 3, and I have to terminate the line using enter. And when I press enter, I'm just going to get the string output again. So this is the whole string that you're reading inside the program. Now let's see what we have to do. We have to read one integer. That's the 3 there. Let me make this bigger actually. All right, so we have to read one integer, which tells us how many more integers are coming. So let's write the code to do this. I'm going to, well, let's say string in n equal to in.nextInt. That's going to be the first integer. And then once I read n, I know how many more integers are coming. So I can have a for loop going up to n. And we're just going to keep on reading integers from the system in. So let's say integer x is equal to in.nextInt. And for each integer that comes in, what do we have to do? We simply have to check if it's a negative number. So I'm going to make a variable called count here. And if now we can say if x is less than 0, then we can say count plus plus. And then we're going to output whatever count is. System.out.inline count. Okay, now let's run this. Let's say I give it 3 numbers, which is going to be 5, minus 3, and minus 4. It prints out 2, which is the number of negative values there. Okay. Now, for each problem, you want to make sure that your program works for the sample input that they give you, meaning that if you put in this sample input, then you'll get the sample output. So I'm going to copy that and just put it inside my program, run it again. Oops, run it again. And press enter, and I get 5. So this looks correct. Well, actually, I'm pretty sure it's correct because it's such an easy problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that code, go to Kattis, go to submit. And now let's go to Java. That took a while. I can just copy and paste my code here. It was class main. Click on submit. And now they're going to test our program. So great. This all means that I pass some test case. And finally, done. All correct. So it is accepted. Now, if you make a mistake in your code, then there's a chance that it will not pass some test cases. And in that case, well, your program simply will be rejected. So if I intentionally make this wrong and try to submit it, let's see what, okay, right away it gets the wrong answer. By the way, don't forget to give the correct main class here. So whatever your name of a class here should go here. You don't have to call it main, you can call it something else, but you have to put the name of the class down there. That's pretty much it when it comes to Kattis submission, and you can get started by doing many of the easy problems on Kattis just to get a feel of system input and output. But I want to close by showing you how to do this via the command line, because we can do better than just copy and paste it into Eclipse. I use something called WSL, or Windows Subsystem for Linux, which basically allows you to use Linux on your Windows machine. If you're using a Mac, then it's already a Linux machine, so you can just use terminal. But if you're using Windows, then I recommend that you download this. Basically, it allows you to use Linux on your Windows machine. Why do you want to do this? Well, first, I think it's always good to have some Unix experience. And secondly, it makes it easier to test your program. For example, I have the main.java file that we wrote earlier. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to compile it. You may need to install Java in order to do this, so I'll leave information on how to install it in the description. Once I compile it using Java C, you see I have main.class here, which is the executable. So I can run it by calling Java main, and it's waiting for our input. So if I put in 5, let's say 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, it's going to give you 2. Okay, great, but isn't this the same thing that we did before? Well, the difference is I can actually write the input in some text file. So let's say I make a file called in.txt and I'll put in 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 5. And say that's our sample input. Okay. Now when I run the main program again, I can pipe in that text file. So instead of typing the sample input every time you run the program, we can put the sample input in the text file, which is then read by the program when we use the arrow symbol here, or, well, that's the less than symbol. Basically, it's like the computer opening the file and then typing in the text into the program. So now, instead of pasting the input every time, I can just rerun this line again and again to test my program. This will get useful when your sample input becomes big, or if you want to try your program with different sample inputs, because I can just write another text file here, let's say in2.txt, and say 3, 1, 2, 3. And if I want to test it with the first input file, then I run in.txt, otherwise I run in2.txt. Easy. You can also use this with official sudo code. So let's say I modify the file from here. So official sudo code is integrated into WSL. So if you just type code main.java, you may have to install official sudo code on WSL. I can't remember, but this will open it up. And you can open up the terminal. We need to go to the right directory. Okay, so you can do the same thing here, right? I can compile, Java C main.java, and then I can run it as before. Done. Okay, that should be enough to get you started. So in summary, go to Kattis, pick a problem, try the easy ones, learn how to do input and output with Java, and that's pretty much it. So good luck, and I hope you enjoy it.